go.
We are standing in front of the memorial that Lloyd Green, the original owner, built. Just to recognize the founder of this was Captain Samuel Adams. He deeded 500 acres with the stipulation that he would now build a sawmill and a grist mill, which is across the stream there. And that was in 1656. His charter was to saw wood so they could build houses to the newly established Chumford, and that was 1656, and grind corn. And he continued that for his family continued that for almost 150 years. And then it went on to the fallow list because technology had overtaken it. But during the 1800s, they did harvest, and we're not looking at the lake just yet, harvest ice, which they then sold to the people of Lowell, and they remained in that business till almost the 1900s. After that, I kind of lost track of how they got from there to here, but I do know that in the lake out there are remnant trees from the great storm and flood of 1938, when all the trees were blown down. The government took all those trees and saved them for the future. And at one time, they were sawing some of those up and selling them to build more houses or rebuild houses in Lowell. And it was not productive until Lloyd came along in 1954, acquired the property, and began to reconstitute it, as you will see here. So that's it.
And how long was this operational?
Lloyd was able to bring, he was searching in the Merrimack Valley area after his property in Boston was acquired by this mass turnpike. He was looking for some place that he could establish the electrical generating capability. By the year 1984, he was able to come online with his water wheel over there, and it was generating electricity and selling into the power grid. Lloyd then subsequently bought himself and established a turbine with which he was generating electricity in another way. Unfortunately, it came online in the early 1990s, but because of the construction, it became inoperable and is so at the moment. But we are just about to bring the water wheel and its generator back online, and we haven't spoken to the power people to see if they're interested in a generation facility or whether we just use it for demonstration.
And, how much power is it capable of generating?
The turbine was capable of generating 25 kilowatts, and the mill was capable of something in the order of 16 to 20 kilowatts. Mm-hmm. So it's not going to put Grand Coulee Dam out of business, but it demonstrated the technology which Lloyd wanted to demonstrate.
So tell me now about what you do here.
Well, when Lloyd passed away in 2011, he had previously, back as early as 2000, set up a prospect to pass this on someday. Caught me not paying attention. attention, and we that I would take over when he passed it on to me, 2011. Now, his request was, would I establish a foundation with it and present it as an educational and a recreational facility for the enjoyment of the people of Chumpsville. He wasn't going to turn it over to the town. He wanted it for you and me. And so the first thing to do was to stabilize all of the building, because he was an inventor, but he was not an avid maintainer. And so there's been some work to be done. And we're approaching that. We have one more building that we have to stabilize, and then we can start paying attention to what is the program that he might visualize, the people might best visualize. And that's the chapter for next week.